How to fix all issues with Black Ops 7 not starting or crashing. Is your game not starting or crashing on Black Ops 7? Watch until the end of this video to learn the fix. I struggled for 2 days trying to get Black Ops 7 to work, and finally, this was the fix that did it for me. If you need the Monster Energy Bundle or the Little Caesars Bundle for Black Ops 7, check out the Ko-fi Shop. Not only is there every limited time Black Ops 6 bundle available, but now there's going to be every limited time Black Ops 7 bundle available. 6-7. Right now there's the Monster Energy Bundle and the Little Caesars Bundle, the Muller Mitch Bundle, and the new EE Mobile Bundle will be available on the Ko-fi Shop very soon. If you guys want to pick up any of these bundles that we talked about, link will be in the description. In the comments. Whether you bought the game through Steam, Battle.net, or Xbox, tons of people have been having issues where they can't launch Black Ops 7 at all. Personally, I'm on Steam, and what was happening for me is I'd click the play button, it would load for like 10 seconds, and then the play button would go back to green. Exactly like that. And it was so annoying, guys. I've been trying to solve the problem for days now, and I finally found a fix, so I'll be sharing with you guys the solution that finally fixed the problem for me, as well as a ton of other fixes. I literally tried every single thing possible to fix my game, guys, so I know all the fixes possible, so make sure you guys watch until the end of the video so you can fix your game and start playing Black Ops 7 right now. Make sure you guys drop a like on the video and subscribe to Fusion here for more Black Ops 7 videos. I'm gonna be making a ton of videos showing you guys how to get free skins and promotions in the game. There's a ton of promos coming out right now, so there's gonna be a ton of new videos, and you guys don't want to miss them. So for the first fix on how to fix Black Ops 7 not starting, update your graphics drivers. Whether you have a NVIDIA graphics card, AMD, or Intel, update your graphics drivers. NVIDIA just released new graphics drivers that say it's game ready for Black Ops 7, so there is a possibility that your game isn't launching because your graphics drivers aren't up to date. And sometimes your graphics drivers could have been installed incorrectly, so it's a good idea to reinstall the latest graphics drivers just to make sure. On the NVIDIA app, up here in the top right, you have the option to reinstall, and when I click this, I can choose either an express or a custom installation. You might want to choose a custom installation if you're reinstalling, and then choose a clean installation. Sometimes you might have some old files around, like some corrupted graphics drivers, that are messing up your graphics card and not letting you play Black Ops 7. So choose the clean installation button, and it's going to perform a clean installation of the latest graphics drivers for your graphics card. I'm going to be making new videos on the Muller Mitch promo, on the new EE Mobile promo, so if you guys don't want to miss all the free skin and promo videos that I'm going to be making for Black Ops 7, make sure you guys are subscribed to the channel, and turn on post notifications and set them to all. The next fix you guys can try is verifying the integrity of your game files. How you do this on Steam is by coming up to the game, right-clicking, going to properties, and coming down to installed files. In here, you have the option to verify the integrity of the game files, let it run through this. If there's any issue with the files of the game, it will fix them, and then you'll be able to launch Black Ops 7. And this is how you do it on the Blizzard launcher. We could try verifying the game files. Now, I have the beta installed through Steam, so I have to show this with Cold War, but you want to come down to the options, little cogwheel down here next to play, and there should be an option that says scan and repair. It says this will perform a scan on your current game to identify missing and corrupt files. You guys want to click begin scan and let this run. This could definitely help you guys out. Your game could have installed incorrectly. Maybe something happened with your Wi-Fi when you were downloading the beta. And by re-verifying the game files, this could definitely fix the beta for you guys. But this still wasn't the fix for me. Make sure you guys watch until the end of the video to hear what fix finally did it for me. For the next fix, you guys want to make sure you didn't disable any services that are required for playing Call of Duty. This could include anything for Steam, anything for Call of Duty, or anything for Call of Duty's anti-cheat for Ricochet. The first way you guys can check is by hitting Windows and the R key and typing msconfig. When you do that, it's going to bring up the system configuration window. You guys want to come over to services and then come down to the bottom and hide all Microsoft services. And now you guys want to scroll down this list and make sure that none of these services that are disabled have anything to do with Steam, Call of Duty, or Call of Duty's Ricochet anti-cheat. After scrolling through all my services, I can confirm that I'm all set. And now the next place I want you guys to check, go back into Run again, which is the Windows key plus R, and type services.msc. Now that we're in here, this is all the services for every app on your computer. And the same way we just did before, you guys want to scroll through and make sure that none of the services for Steam, Call of Duty, or Ricochet anti-cheat are turned off. And if a service you need is disabled, like this one right here, you want to right-click it, go into properties, come up to the startup type, and set it to either manual or automatic. You're going to want to set it to manual unless you want this service to start up with your computer every time you turn it on. Now you guys want to hit apply to save the changes you just made to this service. And now hit OK. Now the next fix I have for you guys is uninstalling programs that aren't compatible with Black Ops 7. When you guys click support for Black Ops 7 on Steam, you want to choose gameplay or a technical issue, and you have 5 different options here. Personally, the game didn't start when I was trying to launch it, so that's the option that I'm going to select. And as you guys can see, Steam says other programs on your computer may be conflicting with Steam. You can click here to see which programs may interfere with Steam, and it gives you a list of different programs here that might be interfering with your game. Now guys, if you have Faceit Anti-Cheat installed, some other FPS games use Faceit Anti-Cheat. This has been reported to cause issues with Black Ops 6 and now Black Ops 7, so if you guys have Faceit Anti-Cheat installed, remove it off of your computer and see if you can now play Black Ops 7. And on the same note, if you have Valorant installed, Valorant has been reported to do the same thing for Black Ops 6 and now Black Ops 7, so if you guys have Valorant installed, remove it off of your computer, and then see if Black Ops 7 starts. And before we get into the last solution, which is what finally fixed Black Ops 7 for me, and now I'm able to play the game, make sure you guys check out the Ko-fi shop if you want to pick up some bundles for Black Ops 7. Right now you can pick up the full Monster Energy bundle for Black Ops 7, as well as Little Caesars codes. You can pick up one Little Caesars code, or buy the 4 code bundle for a better chance at getting all the items in the bundle. If you want to sort by the categories, just for Black Ops 6 or 7, 6-7, we have the BO6 and BO7 categories up at the top. These are all the Black Ops 6 bundles we have, and then you can choose BO7, and these are all the Black Ops 7 bundles we have. The Muller Mitch bundle and the new EE Mobile bundle will be available on the Ko-fi shop very soon, and yes, there's a new EE Mobile promotion just like last year for Black Ops 6 where we got Hella Chill. There's a new Hella Chill for Black Ops 7, guys. Video on that coming very soon. If you guys want to pick up any of these bundles, the link for the Ko-fi shop will be in the description and the comments. Now the last fix for how to fix Black Ops 7 not starting or crashing on startup, any of those type of startup issues, you guys want to uninstall the game and reinstall it. So to do that on Steam, you guys want to come up to Call of Duty, right click, go down to manage, and click uninstall. Once it completely uninstalls, install the game again, and then see if Black Ops 7 works for you. This is what did it for me. This was the fix that finally fixed Black Ops 7 for me. I couldn't believe it. It was the last thing I thought to do because I just reinstalled Call of Duty completely because I got a new SSD. I didn't think that it could be that, but what do you know, I deleted the game and reinstalled it, and now it works. And if this fix was the solution for you as well, make sure you guys let me know in the comments down below. I want to know how many of you guys I helped out with this video. I struggled for 2 days trying to get Black Ops 7 to work, and finally, this was the fix that did it for me. And as you guys can see, I'm finally in Black Ops 7, and it says action required. Your PC does not meet security requirements for Call of Duty. To keep the game and security features up to date, please review and resolve the requirements below. BIOS firmware update required. Now guys, if you have this message on Black Ops 7 when you start up the game, just hit dismiss. It's going to let you into Black Ops 7 and you'll be able to play with no problem. And finally, I'm able to play Black Ops 7. Let's actually load into Black Ops 7 to show that it really works now. And here we are, finally. I paid $100 for this game. I'm sure a lot of you guys did too, or even if you just got the base edition of the game, $70. And now we're finally able to play the game that we paid for. And if this video has helped you fix Black Ops 7 or helped you out in any way so far, make sure you guys drop a like on the video, subscribe to Fusion here, and turn on post notifications and set them to all. And you guys can pick up double XP tokens for Black Ops 7 on the Ko-fi store. I'll have it on the screen right now with what the prices are, but you guys can pick up 1 hour of double XP or 10 hours. So if you guys need some double XP for Black Ops 7, make sure you guys check out the Ko-fi shop, link in the description and comments. But yeah, guys, this has been how to fix Black Ops 7 not starting or crashing on startup, or any of the startup issues or crashing issues for Black Ops 7. If this video helped you out, drop a like, subscribe to Fusion here, and turn on post notifications and set them to all. Remember, I'm going to be dropping new videos showing how to get every new promo for the game. I already made a video on the Monster Energy and the Little Caesars promotions, and now I'm going to be dropping videos on how to get the new Muller Mitch and EE Mobile promos. So if you guys don't want to miss those videos, make sure you have those post notifications turned on. Here on Fusion here, for every Call of Duty video, we do a giveaway. If you guys want to win a free Little Caesars code, Monster Energy codes, or double XP for Black Ops 7, let's go. I got the Little Caesars operator for Black Ops 7. For this video's giveaway, all you guys need to do is drop a like on this video, subscribe to Fusion here, and turn on post notifications and set them to all, and then comment BO7 giveaway. And then the last step is to join the community Discord server. This is what it looks like when you first join. You want to select what platforms you play on. Then it's going to ask you what you want to do in the server. Make sure you guys select this option, trade Call of Duty code / find people to play with. You want to hit next. And then it's going to ask you what game specific channels you want. You want to make sure you select Call of Duty in the top left and then hit finish. And then the last step to enter the giveaway is to come to the COD BO7 channel and type done. I'm going to be coming through and picking multiple of you guys to win this giveaway, so I look forward to seeing you guys in the community Discord server, and good luck. And anyways, guys, this has been Josh Refusion here. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.